We're 475-86 North Grade South, hold short runway 10 right. Remember 475-86 make right downward departure, runway 10 right, clear for takeoff. Remember 8870, Papa, make right downward departure, runway 10 right, clear for takeoff towards the layup group.
Clear for takeoff, runway 10 right, 324.
November 8870, Papa, North Perry Tower, say your location, altitude, sir. November 8870, Papa, roger, make straight in, runway 10 right, report 3 miles.
70, Papa, do you need assistance?
Okay. November 324, runway 10 right, clear, touch and go.
70, Papa, roger, I'll have emergency personnel stand by here at the airfield. Looks like I-75 is just slightly behind you, about a quarter mile. 7-4 Papa Roger, you're going to be able to make it back to the field, sir. It looks like Pembroke Boulevard is just off your right, and also Hollywood or Pines Boulevard is just off your left. Seneca 7-4 Papa, sir, you, can you say it's able, say Foles on board. 7-4 Papa Roger, do you have a visual with Pembroke? It's just slightly off your right. 7-4 Papa Roger, are you, I'd in as observer, are you, what are your intentions? 7-4 Papa Roger, current winds are 050 at 16. Stand by. 684 contact departure 119045. Stand by. 3 Tango Sierra Roger, stand by indefinite delay.
And debris marked the spot where this small plane went down Tuesday. And these crews seen working on the power lines. The plane clipped on its way down, as seen in this dash cam video. The crash tragically killing a flight student and seriously injuring his instructor.
Instantly heard all the sirens, heard the helicopters above. They came instantly.
Miramar police officers say they were trying to fly back to North Perry Airport. At some point, they reported a mechanical issue and tried to make an emergency landing on Pembroke Road near Hiatus. Rescue crews rushed the instructor to Memorial Regional Hospital. Officers say 25-year-old Mark Daniel Scott died in the crash.
All of a sudden, just saw a wall of fire and basically black smoke.
Women Aviation Academy owns the plane. We've learned this is not the first time they've had issues. At least 2 planes experienced mechanical problems as they landed in March and September of 2019. And back in November of 2019, we're told a student was injured when the plane he was in crashed. The Academy's vice president tells 7 News the 2 men on the flight were very experienced and knew exactly what to do in an emergency.
I think they did as well as they could in the situation they were in.
They apparently called air traffic control, letting them know of the mechanical issues. That's when they asked if they would make it to the airport.
You're going to be able to make it back to the field, sir. It looks like Pembroke Boulevard.